Right, we're recording. 1 minute and we'll jump into it. Yeah, I think my buddy Andrew was telling me about that. He sent me the settings as well. I'll have to go and have a look. For now, I'll just re-upload this on YouTube. Right, should we get into it? Let me move some shit over because I've got two screens now. Because that's how I roll. Right. Right, let's do it. So this is our dude Neosonics. Abandoned. Isn't Abandoned the artist? So is this a remix or? We'll get into it anyway. Let's go. To kickstart this off, so Good Pointers is, I love the piano at the start. That sounds like a Hans Zimmer type piano. It sounds sick. The build up is good, but the snare could use like a stronger snare because it kind of sounded a bit weak when it first came in. Yeah, definitely a stronger snare. Yo, what's going on, Insco? Thanks for hopping in, man. Let's pick up a snare. What we got? Do you know, I'm just gonna roll with this one because this one always works for build-ups. I'm gonna do it on a MIDI channel though. Oh, what's wrong with the mic? We're having problems already. God damn. Oh, Chris, is there a problem with door and mic? Ah, shit. All right, give me 2 secs. But when you switch to door, it became stereo. Hold on. So look what I can do. Mic. Mono's ticked. Let me quickly check the settings. Audio. Does anyone know how to do this? Like the whole stream's in stereo mode. Is it stereo good? Mike's just going through a Focusrite. But I've been streaming for the past couple of weeks. I've not really run into this problem before. I was gonna say, how bad is the problem? Do we need to restart or are we good? I don't get that, it's weird. Fuck knows. Alright, we'll just have to roll it for now. If anyone has any ideas on what settings to change, let me know and I'll do that. Cool, let's jump back into this snare. Alright, so I'm not going to like recreate the whole snare pattern, but my point being that, see, that sounds kind of weak at the moment as well. Don't want all that white noise at the end either. Get Pro and B on it. Something like that might be better. You know it, Andrew. Route the mic into Ableton. Would that work? I'd have to have like a audio track set up though, wouldn't I? Actually, Andrew, you might know. Yeah, I'm streaming with OBS. Andrew, do you know how to make my mic mono? Because the feeling I'm getting is that the mic's in stereo. But like on the properties, it says the mic is in mono. I've got mono ticked, which is weird. Let me turn the mic off and on. Is that any better? When I went into Ableton, it switched. That is weird. Still in stereo. What, is it only coming out like the one side, like the left or the right? Alright, sweet. We'll carry on. So yeah, with this Neosonics track. Stop streaming, Ableton. Right, let me go back to this intermission screen. Is the mic in stereo now? It's better now. Okay, but then you guys can't see Ableton. All right, let me go back to Ableton. Maybe there's a glitch. Let's try it again. Any good now? It's back to stereo. I reckon the A1 or something, maybe A1s. Let me go to. I've got no input on Ableton, I've just got the OBS audio, which is what I usually use to stereo. Right, I'm going to try one more thing. You mean one more try? I'm going to. Let me copy this mic and bring it in. Let me get rid of this mic real quick. Yo, any better? God damn. All right, we're just going to have to deal with it, unfortunately. Okay, let's carry on. So back to this track. Yeah, I felt like it needed a better snare on the build-up, like a stronger snare. So it was this before. Now this. And the drop, it sounded like the chord stack had like quite a lot of resonant frequencies in. Because the top end was quite piercing. So it might just be an EQ job. Yeah, around there. Obviously don't do it on your master. It's a individual track type situation, but yeah, that's what I would do. Other than that, dude, it's a great song. Yeah, I really liked it. Sweet. Let's move on to Isaac. I Need a Vocalist Bounce Demo 2. Have much constructive criticism for that. There was just one bit in these gaps where I thought the delays should stop, but other than that, that was it. There's like some delays here. Keep the reverb, but maybe lose the delays is the only thing I'd say. Drops wicked. Yeah, that was a great track. I love this one part here as well. That's sick. That little diddling. That was sick. Right, AUR. Yeah, that was Retrovision vibes actually. Okay, so this is AUR Sound Mojo Remix Master.
Held our vow until the dawn came. It's getting late, no time to waste. Song along to chase the heartache. Won't go away, won't go away. Now I want you to say for me, want you to say for me.
That was sick. That is the sort of tune that we would play out live. That is cool. Had two notes I wanted to point out, and both are the same. On verse one and verse two. Just this contrast here. It goes from quite loud to almost too quiet, it seems, on both sides. And then the same again here. Yeah, I feel like a volume boost is needed there, or maybe a volume cut here going into this bit to give it more impact, because it kind of loses the power when that should come in with more power for the build up. Other than that, it was sick. Like I said, it's sort of a song that we'd play it live, so absolutely wicked. But yeah, just those contrast bits, I think, if you just sort out the volume balance, it'll be wicked. Right, so next up we got Insco, which is kind of funny because usually Insco is reviewing everyone else's songs and has lately as well. So let's take a listen to Nothing I've Felt Before.
I fall in and I never learn. The same flame and I'm always hurt. Picking my pieces from the ashes on the floor.
Vocal sick.
Push away but it's killing me. Smoke lungs when I try to breathe. Filling me up without to hold them in my core.
Yes, Insco, that is sick, mate. That is sick. That vocal chop's wicked, man. I love the use of like the space that you've done in the drop with the vocal chop and the way it interacts with like the other elements there. I thought that was really, really unique actually, because it's definitely like a future-based vibe, but it's like I've not really heard anything like that, which is really cool. I have to agree with what someone said in the comments that you could use a little bit more sub, but I saw that you're still on the mix down, and I know how that is, like, just constant tweaks for, it's never done, but in my opinion, more sub. Other than that, absolutely banging track, mate. Right, should we move on to Solek, New Dawn? What's everyone saying, the audio and stuff? Is it listenable? Like, can... Does it sound like it's got the Haas effect on everything? Just on the mic, okay, sweet. That's the main thing. No one gives a fuck about my voice. Sweet. Let's keep going. Sweet. We'll be right back. God damn, that went hard. That was really cool. That was sick. My only issue is, and I think it's just a mastering thing, was it was a little too loud when it dropped, especially like there was definitely some distortion there, and I noticed it on these pianos here as well. Like you can really hear the distortion, like the compression really really cranking it. So I would sacrifice maybe 1 or 2 dB just so you're not getting that distortion, but compositionally and mixed down, that is fucking sick. That is a good track. I'd be very interested to hear that with some vocals on. I'm assuming that it's intended for vocals. I think Isaac's in the chat. Is this going to get vocaled or? Yeah, sick. Yeah, I'd love to hear that with vocals on, and just the mastering time down, just a dB or two, just so it's not getting over compressed. Next up, we got our boy Fraud. Dude, I haven't actually listened to this version. Is this an updated version to the one last stream, or is it the same one? Yo, Fraud, where you at? How you doing, Callan? Thanks for the follow, man. Uh-oh. Why uh-oh? Should be updated. Okay, sweet. This is Voyage by Fraud. Dude always does the sickest atmosphere, man. We'll be right back. Nice. As always, man, absolutely love your atmospheres. Some of like the better atmospheres I've ever heard, actually, like with all the stuff you've sent me. You definitely have a talent with like the soundscaping, and that really shows, especially like in the intros. And agreed with what you said here, the kicks are definitely too loud in comparison to the chords, so maybe just get a nice balance of those together. What else? Yeah, stronger snare there. And I think a little mix down work is needed to make, because the drop is quieter than the intro stuff. So I'd be pumping this up a little bit and maybe bringing this down just a tad. But it will make a big difference, because if you was to try and leave it there and then it doesn't sound like it's as impactful as needed, what you might end up doing is overproducing, adding more stuff in that's not needed, when all in fact you need to do is pump up the volume. I do prefer the second drop. However, there's some slight problem with the kick underneath the snare. Maybe some EQ work needs doing, or you need a new snare on top of the kick. It's always a difficult thing trying to do like a half-time drop where you've got like a kick and then a kick and a snare on the free. It's hard to make the two work together. So I'd try a few different snares, maybe even a few different kicks, just to try and get one cohesive thing, because you can definitely, you can tell that they're kind of conflicting at the moment. But other than that, I love it, dude. I think this part is still a bit long as well. I think that this bit is such a moment that you shouldn't drag it out too long. I'd cut it off there and go straight into the... You know, like... For a live show or something, it's perfect to keep it longed out and build up hype, but I think for listening purposes, I'd maybe cut that, do like a little radio edit version. Sick. Let's go to Herlock Sholmes. Herlock Sholmes. Let's do it. Yo, did anyone else expect that second drop? Because I did not. That was cool, man. Love the piano. The drop is really cool. BPM automation at the outro, please. So yeah. Drums are sick, synths are sick, the whole track is really good, and the vocals are really cool as well. Actually, it's got like a darker vibe to it, which I think is really nice. Like, it suits the whole thing, is very cohesive, it really works. Sweet. Let's quickly read chat. Yeah, actually, I can see that on NCS. That'd be a good shout, actually. I don't think Herlock Sholmes is in the chat, is he? No, that's a shame. Okie doke, let's carry on to Alicanto and Falling. And if I'm falling. Pretty eyes got me blinded just like city lights. Your lips and mine, we paint the truth with all these pretty lies. Nobody knows the way I feel and no one knows what you do to me. If I let go, would you hold on or would you just let me fall in free? Pretty eyes got me blinded just like city lights. And if I'm falling, would you be the one or just ignore me? Even if I lose my mind, just say you won't let me down. And if I'm falling, just say that you won't ever let me go. Like your last goodbye. Nobody knows the way I feel and no one knows what you've done to me. Though I held on, you let me go and now I'm just keeping falling free. I don't know why. Just let me know that if I'm falling, would you be the one or just ignore me? Even if I lose my mind, just say you down. And if I'm falling, just say that you won't ever let me go. How sick was that? That sounds like it's ready for radio. Definitely like a Chainsmokers, Lost Kings type vibe. I love drops that are like very spacious as well. I know we don't do it a lot because it's not really our style. We did it in Fairy Tale, but you know when it like drops and it's got like just guitars, like one bass hit, space, then guitars, and then like percussion, and then comes back in. That is wicked. Vocal chops are sick as well. I've got no constructive feedback for that. Loved it. Oh, NCS taking more like pop stuff lately. That's interesting. That's cool though. I guess everything sort of evolves and moves on over time. Right, let's go. So we got Shadow next. Let's jump into it. Jesus, that sounds loud. Looks loud, sorry, should I say. They're accepting Color Base and Color Trap. That does look loud as hell. Let's see what it's about. Contrary to what the guys are saying in the chat, I would actually like to see that with vocals on, but that's just because I'm like a vocal person anyway, and it seems like there's a lot of room for vocals, but that's it to each own's opinion. was not expecting drum and bass either. That was a surprise. That was wicked, man. Mastering's really good as well. Like it looks loud as hell, but it wasn't overdone. It wasn't overcooked. Yeah, I would. If you do get vocals, please send it back because I'd love to hear what that would sound like. It just looks like it's waiting for vocals. If you know what I mean, like there's a lot of space for vocals to fit on there, especially with that 80s vibe. But yeah, it's cool. Love the second drop as well with the melodic dubstep switch up. Sick. Yeah. The scratchy sort of hat noises at the end were cool, but maybe they were a bit too loud in the mix. Only like 1 or 2 dB. Yeah, barely a life clap would be sick actually. Let's see what everyone's saying. What is dance floor? Man, I cannot keep up with these genres. No, I haven't heard of that genre. Oh, okay. Man, I am out of it with genres, like old man vibes. I do not know the new genres. I don't even know when melodic dubstep turned into future bass. EDM is EDM. Right, so this is AUR's track, which we missed last time. Wow. That was my bad. I forgot to press record. Do you mean when future bass turned into melodic dubstep? Dude, when we were doing melodic dubstep, there was no such thing as future bass. And all of a sudden it was just, yeah, so this track's future bass now. So genuinely, I don't even know what to call like the stuff that we make anymore. I just put like melodic dubstep, melodic dubstep dash future bass. Oh yeah, definitely. I'd never heard of future bass for like years. I only heard of it about 3-4 years ago. Melodic dubstep was going way before that.
You call me, do you feel alone? I know that you miss me, but you are so down. You know that I'm here. Come when you want, you know I'll always pray for you, little boy. I know, yeah. I know that you miss me, I know that you miss me. I know that you miss me, I know that you miss me.
Sick. So I think I'll just stick with my feedback I said last time, because I've got no real constructive criticism of it mixed down wise or anything like that. The only note that I do have is if you're trying to get it signed by a label, might be difficult with four different genres of drops. But at the same time, do you, man? Like, it's not very often you can say which was your favorite drop, 1, 2, 3, or 4. Which is, I guess if you make that your thing, then that's what you'll be known for. You'll be like the multi-genre guy. It just might be hard initially pitching to labels, because I can't see any reason why NCS wouldn't have took this production-wise, because it's a great track. The only thing I can think of is the fact that it's four different genres, and they might struggle to pitch that. But other than that, like, it's cool as shit. Personally, my favorite drop was number 3, with that guitar that came in, or like at least it's a guitar lead. It sounds convincing. Is that real guitar? Because if not, I want that plugin. It's a freestyle. Ah, okay. Real guitar. That's sick. God damn it, 4V. With the Hardwell again. Dude, do you not know who Hardwell is? Has it been that long since he's been out of the game? Okay, good. I was gonna say, like, Big Room never dies. Sweet. Ah, fraud. Where you at? No fraud. You sent another track. Is that one updated from last time as well? Because if so, I'll quickly get it in. Yo, what's up? How you are? You can hear my breath. Damn, this thing's supposed to be gated. Is gated. That's weird. Only in your left ear. What the fuck? Yeah, it's updated. Okay, let's go drag it in. Where are we at? Let's do feedback. Yeah, it's updated. How do you make music? Yeah, man, just stick at it. Sonic Sad. It's a long game, but it's worth it. Been doing it 10 years now. Culture Code is 10 years old this year. Chris, what advice would you give to this? Hey guys, does somebody advice for giving me song arrangement and instrumental music? I quite struggle a bit there since I don't have vocals. I'm currently focused on instrumental music. Yo, what's up, Fabian? Are you trying to put vocals in your tracks, or do you want to stick to instrumental music? Like, what's the goal? Make me move, man. That was some time ago now. That was what, 2015, 2016? God damn. Guys, time goes fast. I'm not sure if Fabian's still there, but we'll still answer his question. Oh, Fabian's back. Actually, my goal is to do similar music style. Oh, thanks, man. Glad you like our music. In 10 years, maybe. But currently, I don't have any vocals, so I just stick for instrumental music at the moment. Well, the good news is you don't have to do that. What we like to do is, if we don't have any vocals to start off with, you can grab some remix vocals. Just go on YouTube, just type in like studio a cappella, or just any of your famous artists. Like if you like Illenium, type in Illenium a cappella. Do like the usual YouTube to MP3 and drag that in. And what you can do is you can build a track, and then from there you can remove the vocals afterwards. And then start an original track, just as long as you don't tailor that remix too close to the original. So it might be a good idea to change the key, like pitch up or down the vocals, change the chord progression, but just use the vocals as a basis to if you've got the vocals in there and you build the track around it, then when you get new vocals in, they're more than likely going to fit because you left space for that vocal range. That would be my advice. It's something that's always worked for us, so definitely give that a try. Yeah, there are free acapellas as well. I don't think it's bad to work with a remix vocal as well, as long as you don't make it so obvious. Yeah, let's get into Fraud's track. I really liked this last time. Let's see what's been changed.
Thank you.
know, the melody and the chord progression of that is so sick. That's what I really loved about it last time. It sounds like you've buried that lead a little bit more in the harder drop, which sounds better. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. This string here is mono. You slap three wideners on it. It sounds just completely mono, to be honest, dude. No, it doesn't sound mono, actually. It does sound really... It's weird. It appears mono, but it's not. Yeah, if it's just the way the sound is, I'd switch them out for some different strings then. What we saying about the drop? Yeah, could definitely use like a fresh mix down. Make sure that there's no basses and stuff conflicting with the kicks. What's everyone saying? Do you have any other string plugins? I think Fraud does use Labs. I think these strings are from Labs, if I'm not mistaken. Lanium is my biggest inspiration. This would be a nice approach, but without vocals would be something missing then. Or do you mean I need to fill the space then with something else? Yeah, I mean what you've said there, dude, that when you had the vocal sample, it was much easier for you. So say, like, for instance, in the streams lately, we've been doing a remix of Elenium's Nightlight. But it could go either way. Like, if the song turned out well, we could remove the vocal and get an original vocal on it. It's probably not going to happen because it was just for streaming purposes. But the point being that you build it with a vocal. If you struggle to build instrumentally, then it's best to build with a vocal, then remove the vocal and send out that instrumental to different vocalists. That's the approach I would take. Sweet. Right, I'm gonna. Is it cool if I show you guys a new track that we've just finished up? Yeah, sure, man. Send it on Discord. Oh shit! No, let's listen to. Fuck, I've already showed the title. No, I haven't showed the title. We're good. Because you guys can't see the title. We'll listen to your track first. And then I'll show this track so I can chop it off the end of the thing.